the end of 2012, what was really interesting was watching how the quartet changed in that time, and actually watching how our choice of repertoire has changed and how the way we work has changed. So it's full days, and that's a different way of working than just having a three-hour rehearsal that's slotted into a part of your day. So when we work on the Flinders Quartet now, it's our full focus, and that brings something, that obviously brings something different to the previous years. We try and balance those things that we love and that actually are essential for a string quartet to play, like Beethoven's Opus 131 that we're playing in 2015, Dvorak's American Quartet, which we all love, anything by Haydn and anything by Mozart, pieces that we love, as well as Shostakovich. We try and balance that with new works that we're premiering from other composers. We were talking to Jen about how we could work together again. We premiered the Reinventions with her in 2005. We wanted to play that with her again, but in a different kind of way. And she suggested working with Paul Grabowsky, and we'd always wanted to work with him, but we hadn't actually had the guts to ask him. So based on Jen's suggestion, we rang Paul, and he really wanted to write us a piece, and so we asked him to write a piece based on Oscar Wilde's The Nightingale and the Rose, because that's a piece of literature that we'd always thought would work really well in a chamber music format. And he wrote us this most amazingly evocative piece, which is not programmatic, it doesn't tell the story itself, but it really gives us the sense of what love is and love lost and how futile love is. You do kind of run around in circles a little bit, and having this added injection of genius from these two amazing musicians is what we try and do every year. We try and work with people that are really going to lift us up onto another level. Thank you.